Our first speaker of the day needs no introduction. René Jansen is chairman of the Netherlands Gaming Authority, the Dutch gambling regulator. We are extremely happy to have him with us today. Hopefully, he can shed some light on what we expect in the coming months. Thank you, René, for being here in these difficult times. Over to you, and welcome to the stage.
COVID times. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Here, I'm very glad that you all could join us here, both physically in this lovely Beurs van Berlage and remotely by live stream wherever you are looking. Willem van Noort, my sincere thanks once again for inviting me to speak here today. This is really the first time I have been able to speak in front of a live audience since the COVID-19 pandemic made its presence felt in Europe. And I can say it is a great feeling being here. Our coming together now is especially gratifying because of the crucial months we are having in front of us. That applies to the Kansspelautoriteit, or KSA, but also for you. At gatherings like this one, my predecessor and I have frequently expressed the expectation that the Remote Gambling Act, Wet Kansspelen op afstand, or COA as I will name it sometimes, would soon be a reality. Or alternately, that the KSA had announced that, unfortunately, its introduction had again been delayed. Now, however, the moment has actually arrived. The countdown has begun, despite what I saw now in the poll. In all likelihood, the Remote Gambling Act, COA Act, will enter into effect on the 1st of March 2021. This means that from that date on, it will be possible to submit applications for online gambling licenses. And that, in turn, means that the online gambling market will open up on the 1st of September next year. KSA staff has worked extremely hard in the recent period. From your perspective, some of those efforts were less visible as most of the work took place behind the scenes. As you know, the new Act is an extremely detailed piece of legislation. In the interest of players and to prevent gambling addiction, no aspect of the Act can be left to chance. Once the Act had been passed by Parliament in February 2019, the Ministry needed to draft a great deal of subordinate legislation and present it to the House of Representatives. The House adopted several motions, which then had to be incorporated. After that, the next step was the still ongoing notification procedure with the European Commission in order to verify conformity with the internal EU market. Also ongoing at the moment is an advisory process with the Council of State, which is responsible for evaluating the quality of legislation. All of which is to say that this process is certainly no walkover, even before the coronavirus simultaneously reared its ugly head. In any case, we can now plan for the 1st of March next year as a start date for applying for a license to offer online gambling. The Minister for Legal Protection, Sander Dekker, has allowed no time to go waste and has shown a great ability to stay on course. For that, I feel we owe him our gratitude, and it deserves to be said. I'm firmly convinced that in a regulated market, we will be much better able to protect consumers from dangers of online gambling than is currently the case. As it happens, this is precisely the reason why the KSA exists, to ensure that consumers can play safely. The KSA has taken full advantage of the time required for the legislative process. We've developed the Central Exclusion Register, CREX, and handed over to an operational managing enterprise by the name Net Company. The data safe, in Dutch we call it the Controle Databank, CDB, which is the instrument online operators will use to monitor gambling behavior, and that will serve as the basis for KSA's supervision of the operators, is ready to go. Once the notification process for the CDB has been completed with the European Commission, we will publish the technical requirements. This will probably be next month. We've also been hard at work drafting the various necessary policy rules. Via these policy rules, the KSA is translating laws and regulations into real-world practice in connection with implementation and supervision. Next month, we will arrange a consultation regarding the draft policy rule on responsible gambling. Market parties like yourself will have an opportunity to respond to what the KSA expects of you in terms of addiction prevention and advertising. The draft policy rule for remote gambling, we call it our COA rule, COA beleidsregel, will then follow in November. In practical terms, this rule will serve as the foundation for the license application procedure, in which we will demonstrate how the KSA translates the legal requirements into conditions for an online gambling license. I just started. Another area in which we've made progress is a draft scheme for standards, testing standards or assessment standards regarding the technical gambling platforms. The COA Act requires operators to arrange independent testing of all aspects of the gambling platforms. We aim to publish the final testing scheme in November, which will be informed in part by experiences from practical assessments by a small number of testing organizations and some operators. The specifics of which documents and information you can expect to receive from the KSA in the coming period, and when you can expect these, can be found on our website. We have published the COA calendar there as well. That calendar focuses on three target groups: the land-based operators, online operators, and the remaining stakeholders, such as municipalities and healthcare institutions that provide addiction treatment. I can't emphasize this strongly enough. It is vital that each of you effectively prepares for the license application. The process is extremely involved. The goal of the legislator is to see that only those operators who place a high value on responsible gambling will receive a silence. If that is not true in your specific case, the KSA will not and cannot issue you a license. I will be frank. The KSA also stands to benefit themselves from effective preparation on your part. If your applications are incomplete or otherwise submitted without the proper diligence, you are at risk of being denied the license or having that license issued later than 6 months after submission. But such issues cost time and energy on KSA's part as well. We would prefer to spend that time and energy processing carefully prepared and complete applications. So you and we therefore have a common interest in this regard. In order to ensure a smooth process on our side, the KSA is currently setting up a temporary department for the purpose of processing the license applications. This COA licenses department will be staffed by employees of KSA itself, supplemented by temporary staff we will hire and train ourselves. My colleague Geraldine Huysoon, here in front of me, will be head of department of the COA licenses. In designing the procedure, a great deal of attention is being devoted to IT aspects. Applications will be submitted online, and we will receive them via a digital portal. On KSA's end, the applications must then reach the relevant specialists at the proper moment. In short, you can rest assured that KSA is doing everything in its power to see that starting on the 1st of March, it is able to process license applications in a streamlined way within a period of 6 months. I can imagine that there are those among you with a burning question on the tip of your tongue: how will the 1st of March start date impact the well-known so-called Postuma parliamentary motion? In this motion, the Senate has asked the minister to see to it that operators who apply for a license in the Netherlands must have refrained from actively and specifically offering their online gambling services to the Dutch market for at least 2 years prior to their license application. The answer to your question is that when we receive an application for a license, we will look at the applicant's activities for a period of 2 years and 8 months prior to the date of their application. So that means 32 months. The review period of this 2 years and 8 months reflects the delay incurred in relation to the date on which the law was previously intended to enter into force. In other words, an operator who applies for a license on the 1st of March 2021 will need to have ensured that their offerings have not been targeting, specifically actively targeted, Dutch consumers from 1st of July 2018 on. To assess whether that is the case, we will examine certain criteria. These include, but are not limited to, making use of the Dutch language and payment platforms popular in the Netherlands. We published them earlier on our website. And in order to be eligible for a license, operators must also have had adequate age verification in place from the 1st of January 2020 on, in order to effectively prevent minors from participating in gambling. I will have a look at time. Do I have 1 minute? So that means that I have to skip one part of my presentation. It will be published on the website of KSA, so you can read it there again. I wanted to address the land-based operator specifically, but I'll have another chance to do that in another way. So, ladies and gentlemen, I wrap this up now. The KSA will be providing you with a great deal of information in the coming months. Information about which documents you will need to have ready to submit, about the exact conditions that will need to be met, and about how the KSA will assess license applications when the time comes. I urge you to review this information carefully. And by you, I mean the individual operators. But I also mean industry representatives, industry organizations, such as Van Kansspelen, EGBA, and the still-fledgling association NOGA, or NOGA in Dutch, who also have a role to play in preparing the online and land-based operators, as do the authorized representatives like lawyers with submitting the license applications. Starting that process in a timely fashion will benefit you greatly down the road. And with that suggestion, I'd like to conclude these remarks. I will be happy to answer some questions you may have, but for now, thank you very much for your attention.
Please stay here for a moment, René.
Yeah.
There's still a possibility for you to ask the questions in Slido. We also have a boom microphone with a hangle here in the room. But for COVID safety, it would be best if you ask any questions in the Slido app. Let's go to Regie. Can we go to Slido? And can we have Geert the boom here? No questions yet in Slido. Then we have a question from the room here. Can you please state your name and your company? And stand up.
Justin Fransen, Kalfkatsen Fransen. René, I'm sorry you got cut off there on your speech. Must be a bit of a disappointment for the land-based sector not to hear your speech. I have a burning question on the tip of my tongue, which is the following. You are referencing to the motion Postema and the cooling off criteria and so forth. And as you were explaining, you're working on the finalization of the policy rule now.
Yeah.
And I was listening very, very closely to what you said on payments. And if I look at the draft policy rule currently, it says, and I'm going to quote here for a second, for the purposes of the offered games of chance, payment methods which are solely or primarily used by Dutch residents could be used. So that's one of the criteria.
Yep.
And obviously everyone in this room understands that's ideal, right?
Yep.
But now you, it might be semantics or I might be misinterpreting what you said, but now you said payment methods which are popular in the Netherlands. Well, credit card payments are also popular, but they're not typically Dutch payment instruments. So could you maybe elaborate on that? Because it makes me a little bit nervous when you say that.
Okay. Yes, yeah, I think it's. I referred to our former publication of the draft policy rule, and then I quote here, others, typically Dutch payment methods, specifically ideal. So I think you may count on that, that will be the phrase we're going to use in our policy rule that will be published very soon.
So we'll stay the same, essentially, that's what
yes.
you said. Okay,
yes,
thank you.
I didn't mean to put in some new words
okay.
in this statement.
Then I'm at ease. Thank you.
Great. Time for a second question here. We have a question from the Slido audience. Will those fined operators be able to operate illegally during the cool-off period? René?
Sorry.
Sorry. The question is in front of me.
What do you consider a reliable operator?
No, sorry, the first question. The yellow mark. Sorry. Apologies. Will those fined operators be able to operate, between brackets, illegally during the cooling off period?
This is a hard question to say.
We can also get back in our
written report.
Of course,
we all know that until you've got a license for online gambling, offerings are illegal by rule. It's a new act that creates the possibility to have a license, and you can so. Legal offerings, in the strict sense of the word, is only possible when you gain a license.
Okay.
We have, all, of course, our enforcement priority criteria, and Justin Fransen mentioned one of them, and that is the guideline, in a certain sense, for our enforcement activities. The basic line stays the same. Offering online gambling without a license is illegal in the Netherlands.
Great. René Janssen, thank you very much for your contribution, and I'm sure we'll speak to you later. Thank you.
Thank you very much.